Hello, I'm Carol with Green Village Green, and I am interviewing all of the mayoral candidates for the upcoming election for Knoxville Mayor. This is going to be fun. I've done it before. So here is Marshall Stair. You can see he's well labelled here. And this will be my first interview, but all the interviews will have the same questions. So Marshall, in your opinion, how important is sustainability and the climate crisis for you and for Knoxville?
Well, first of all, thank you for coming out. Thanks for coming out here,
everybody with
yes,
me.
All your camera crew here and the tripod. But, in terms of, I think it's very important, and I got my start in politics working on environmental issues. I work for a group called the Public Interest Research Group. And we were working on clean air and climate and protecting national forests. And this was back in 2002. And so it's as someone that's always been a lover of outdoors, it's something that's so important. And what we're seeing, what we're seeing is that the predictions are right, that we're seeing, higher climates, higher temperatures, more extreme weather events, all that thing. And so I think it is a crisis, and it's going to take efforts from every level of government, citizens, businesses, everyone working to reduce it, because we have a system that we produce a lot of carbon, so we're going to have to change that. But I think it's not gloom and doom. I think there's a lot of optimism. There's jobs. I think it will improve the environment, people's quality of life. A lot of things I've been talking about in my campaign: more walkable communities, reducing car trips, making buildings more energy efficient. And then also the city, I think, can have a big impact. We have a lot of vehicles, from all the police vehicles, fire trucks, public service, their vehicles, making those electric, getting them to have a much less carbon footprint. So.
Great, so it's important to you,
and
it's important to Knoxville.
Definitely.
All right, question number two. Well, I guess you've answered that. Why do you think that? But did you answer that? You really did answer that. Think it's important.
Well, I mean, it's a problem that not only we're facing in Knoxville, in Tennessee, the United States, the world. I mean, it is a global problem, and everyone's going to have to be involved in the solution. And I think what's great about where we are now is that cities can take a role in leading on this issue. We're seeing dysfunction in Washington, and so I think it's going to be up to the city to come up with common sense solutions on how do we move the needle, how do we get to zero carbon.
Yes, and Knoxville has been pretty good about being aware of sustainability, so.
Right.
Continue that.
And one of the things I supported on council that really had a big impact was a switch to LED lights. I feel like we did that at the right time. A lot of the comments have been positive about the quality of the light, and it's reduced our bill dramatically. And it's paying for itself. I mean, so the idea that it's not good, and rational for sort of the dollars and cents of it, it's not true. I mean, this is a great example. Yes, it did cost millions of dollars. We took out a bond, but the savings we're getting from the LED, that's what's paying the bond. So
that's good.
And we've reduced our carbon footprint.
All right, question number three. Where in Knoxville do you see the most need? And are there any areas that you would specifically focus on?
Well, in terms of cities, I think where we have the most ability to, sort of move the needle is the efficiency of our buildings. So how much electricity each building used, insulation, windows, doors, roofs, that type of thing. And so I think the city needs to lead the way in its own buildings, and then also help individuals do that. And we need, in the segment that's sort of hardest to reach are landlords and tenants, because a tenant pays electric bills, but they're not going to invest in insulation and things that could reduce that bill. So that's where the city and we've worked on with TVA and KUB on working on those, creating incentives for landlords to make those investments to reduce the bill. The other, as I mentioned earlier, is the tailpipe. It's about reducing trips, You know, the city, obviously, we're not in control of the fuel economy standards for GM and the car manufacturers. But what we can do is provide options for people so they don't have to take a car trip for every task. Those welcoming communities have been a big part of what I've been about since I've been on council. And the good thing about it is that's where we're seeing the market go. People want to live in these communities. They don't want to have to get in a car. And the other part about that, as I mentioned, is the fleet, the vehicle, city vehicles. We do have control over those, moving to electric buses, moving to more fuel-efficient vehicles in police, fire, and public service. That's where I think we can have a big impact.
Is there an area that you think is more important to work with than other areas here?
Well, I guess one that I didn't mention is transit. You know, making transit more user-friendly.
I'm sorry, you've really answered that. I was thinking of physical areas, but this is...
Physical area, no. I don't think there's, you know, one side is different than the other. You know, obviously, you know, in terms of solar, you've got, you know, you need to face south and those kind of things. But in terms of one area of the city, no, I don't think there's...
Yeah, that made a whole lot much more sense. So how would you put... You sound as if you have many plans. Uh-huh. How would you put a plan, the plans, into action?
Well, we have an Office of Sustainability, and I would certainly keep that in...
Erin Gill is a friend of mine.
Yes, she's done a magnificent job since I've worked with her at the city, and, you know, a real a tremendous asset for the city. So I think as we're adopting new standards, we're voting on them, I believe, next council
meeting.
This
is the recode?
No, this is our new goals. So in 2000, before I got on council, we adopted a goal of reducing emissions 20% by 2020. Well, we're going to hit that. A big part is the LED lights. So now we're adopting new goals, and that's reducing 50% by 2030 for the city, and then 80% for the city as a whole by 2050. So audacious goals, and so we're gonna have to take the steps to get there. But using the Office of Sustainability, and I think that first step is in the fleet, especially with electric buses, and there's different grants by the federal government. So using that money to make sure our fleet's more efficient. But also the other thing is improvements to CAT so more people use it. So not only are the buses more efficient, but you've also reduced, if you get more choice riders, then they're, you know, you're sort of killing two birds with one stone.
And the new apps are probably helpful too,
right?
So you know what's coming and when it's coming.
Right. What I've talked about is apps, bus shelters, you know, raising awareness of what it is. It is easy. I take the bus regularly. I think it's also about working with employers, especially downtown, making sure their employees have that option and are aware of that. You know, so making sure they can give discounts to the employees that use transit.
Great. Last question. I mean, you've kind of answered this, but I think I'm thinking of this more from you yourself rather than, well, you're never you yourself as a mayor, are you?
No.
In what time frame do you see this happening? You've talked about the lowering the carbon emissions and
right, the goal of 50% by 2030. I think that's the time frame, you know.
Okay.
And so what steps can we take to get there? And looking at sort of our fleet, and I haven't had the time to know when that would be, but that would be
my goal. That would be your first goal.
Yes.
Getting the vehicles.
And you know, this person, you know, if you're able to serve two terms, you know, of course, there's always re-election, and you know, I'm being involved in this. You never take anything for granted. But you know, the next mayor could be there for 8 years, and that's taken us to, you know, to 2027. So that's a lot of work needs to be done during those years.
Thank you so much. Those were my questions. You did great.
All right. Well,
I knew you would.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much for coming out.
And I have to tell the viewers that I'm not allowed to vote in this election, because I live just outside Knoxville, so I'm the person to be. Not going to move.
There's still time to move.
No.
it's July. You would need to sign a lease this week because the deadline is, I think it's July 29th.
No, so I'm staying put, but thank you very much.
All right. Well,
thank you, Marshall.
All right. Thank you for coming out.